ಸರಸ್ವತ್ಯೈ ನಮಃ ಓಂ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರುಭ್ಯೋ ನಮಃ ಓಂ ಸಮಸ್ತ ಜನಕಲ್ಯಾಣೇ ನಿರತಂ ಕರುಣಾಮಯಂ ನಮಾಮಿ ಚಿನ್ಮಯಂ ದೇವಂ ಸದ್ಗುರುಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮವಿದ್ವರಂ ಸದ್ಗುರುಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮವಿದ್ವರಂ ಓಂ ಶುಕ್ಲಾಂಬರಧರಂ ವಿಷ್ಣುಂ ಶಶಿವರ್ಣಂ ಚತುರ್ಭುಜಂ ಪ್ರಸನ್ನವದನಂ ಧ್ಯಾಯೇತ್ ಸರ್ವವಿಘ್ನೋಪಶಾಂತಯೇ ವ್ಯಾಸಂ ವಸಿಷ್ಠನಕ್ತಾರಂ ಶಕ್ತೇ ಪೌತ್ರಮಕಲ್ಮಷಂ ಪರಾಶರಾತ್ಮಜಂ ವಂದೇ ಶುಕತಾತಂ ತಪೋನಿಧಿಂ ವ್ಯಾಸಾಯ ವಿಷ್ಣುರೂಪಾಯ ವ್ಯಾಸರೂಪಾಯ ವಿಷ್ಣವೇ ನಮೋ ವೈ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ನಿಧಯೇ ವಾಸಿಷ್ಠಾಯ ನಮೋ ನಮಃ ವಸುದೇವಸುತಂ ದೇವಂ ಕಂಸಚಾಣೂರಮರ್ದನಂ ದೇವಕೀ ಪರಮಾನಂದಂ ಕೃಷ್ಣಂ ವಂದೇ ಜಗದ್ಗುರುಂ ಕೃಷ್ಣಂ ವಂದೇ ಜಗದ್ಗುರುಂ ನಾರಾಯಣಂ ನಮಸ್ಕೃತ್ಯ ನರಂ ಚೈವ ನರೋತ್ತಮಂ ದೇವೀಂ ಸರಸ್ವತೀಂ ವ್ಯಾಸಂ ತತೋ ಜಯಮುದೀರಯೇತ್. ನಮೋ ವಸಿಷ್ಠಾಯ ಮಹಾವ್ರತಾಯ ಪರಾಶರಂ ವೇದ ನಿಧಿಂ ನಮಸ್ತೆ. ನಮೋಸ್ವನಂತಾಯ ಮಹೋರಗಾಯ ನಮೋಸ್ತು ಸಿದ್ಧೇಭ್ಯ ಇಹಾಕ್ಷಯೇಭ್ಯ ನಮೋ ಋಷಿಭ್ಯ ಪರೇಶಾಂ ದೇವೇಷು ದೇವಂ ವರದಂ ವರಾಣಾಂ ಸಹಸ್ರಶೀರ್ಷಾಯ ನಮಃ ಶಿವಾಯ ಸಹಸ್ರನಾಮಾಯ ಜನಾರ್ದನಾಯ.
ಸೊ ದ ಉತ್ತಂಕ ಬುರಿ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಗಿವೆನ್ ದಟ್ ಇಯರ್ ರಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ದಟ್ ಗುರು ಪತ್ನಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಗುರು ಎಂಕ್ವೈರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಈ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಇಟ್ ದ ಸೀಕ್ರೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ನಾಗಲೋಕ ಆಲ್ ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ Uttanka took leave of his guru and he straight went to Hastinapur to meet Janamejaya. There we stopped yesterday. When he reached there, Janamejaya was actually celebrating the success over Takshashila. He went to Takshashila, that knows the point we saw. So he was celebrating with all the councils and ministers around him. He was happy. And he was sharing the joy of that. That time Uttanka entered. So Uttanka has seen Janamejaya happy very much. And immediately Uttanka, of course, was well received by the king. And he was given a place, asan. All that was regular. The Atithi Satkar is over. Then Uttanka told him beautiful thing. He said, what exactly you are supposed to do is not being done. And in its place, you are doing something else. What we are supposed to do, you are not doing it. But in that place, you are doing something else in its place. He told that. So Janamejaya said, immediately, please tell me, sir, what is that I am not doing my, what I am supposed to do? And what is that I am doing something else? So Uttanka said, your father, that is Parikshit, was killed by a Takshaka. And Takshaka was a very cruel nature. Takshaka only killed your father. You must take revenge against this Takshaka now. Something you must take revenge. For which you must perform Sarpa Yaga for the destruction of all the snakes, snake jati itself. And this was mentioned in Shastras, Vedas, how to do Sarpa Yajna. Was mentioned. Now the time has now come for you, it has come now for you to perform Sarpa Yajna. And somehow you see that it is fulfilled, accomplished as early as possible. Even though your father was innocent, Parikshit, and he did not commit any sin, still he was killed by Takshaka. In fact, to help your father, when that curse was pronounced by Shrungi, that Muni Kumara, a Brahmana heard about this, Kashyapa Brahmana. And actually he was going to, he has a medicine to treat or to heal Parikshit. As soon as Takshaka bites him, he can bring out the poison down totally. He had that medicine with him, Kashyapa Brahmana. He was actually approaching him, going to Parikshit to tell him that, don't worry, I am there now. Let Takshaka do his job, but I will definitely bring down the poison, and I will see that you are alive. That medicine I have today. But en route, Takshaka appeared in another form, disguise, and discouraged him and offered him, lured him, lot of wealth and everything, and he was actually taken away from the job. This was again, this was mentioned to Janamejaya by Uttanka. So, such is Takshaka, what he did was, that is the kind of, he wanted to kill your father. So at the earliest you must perform yajna and destroy that Takshaka. Should not spare him. Moreover, Takshaka, he had also put some obstacles on my path. When my guru Patni had asked to bring earrings, that fellow stole it away and he put lot of hurdles and difficulties on my path. Why Uttanka is saying to Janamejaya? Because you are a king and you are supposed to take care of, protect the people. Brahmanas, we can't directly curse anybody unless it is required. But we are reporting you to the matter first. So you are supposed to protect us. So I am bringing the matter to you. So you must do something. I am coming here for justice also. And same fellow had killed your father also. I tell you, the moment this was heard by Janamejaya, he was so much angry. He was burning. And immediately he asked the other ministers and counselors around him, "Ye sach hai kya? Ye mura, you please tell me now, how my father died. Give the details, more details of it." Thus he was burning and inquiring. So, and then the Janamejaya was so much depressed and dejected listening to about his father's death. He became sorrowful and miserable and drowned in the ocean of sorrow. That is the thing. Tadaiva hi sa rajendraha dukkha shokaplutu abhavat yadaiva vruttam pitaram uttankad asrunot tada. As soon as he heard the story of his father from Uttanka, he was drowned in sorrow. Thus we have completed that particular parva called Paushya Parva. Is it not? Next comes is Pauloma Parva. Paulo Upaparva. Parva means Upaparva only here, not the Nari Parva. We are seeing the Upaparvas. Upaparvas. Now, here again, the Katha Pravesha, it is called actually. We enter into the, slowly, don't expect immediately Mahabha, the Pandavas and Kauravas. They will come later on. So, a lot of things we have to know. Here, one day, the Naimisharanya, Shaunaka Rishi, again that story comes, he was performing a huge yajna for 12 years, it was running. Meant for 12 years, Mahayajna he was performing in Shaunaka. Shaunaka the Rishi, Shaunaka is the chief of it. So, there what happened? Our Ugrashrava, Lomaharshana's son, he had entered into that Maharshi. He was also going there and he went there. Now, who is that? Pauranika Purane Krutashramahasa Krutanjalistanuvacha Kimbhavanta Srotu Michyanti Kimaham Brivaniti. He said, this master of Pauranas actually he is. So he went to the congregation of those 88,000 rishis were there actually in those days. All of them he addressed and said, please tell what is it you want to listen from me. I have come here to spend some time. Chali Poochya.
Tam rushayah uchuhu paramam lomaharshane vakshama vakshyamastvam naha prati vakshya vakshyasi vachastu srushatam katha yogam na katha yoge.
Now, they all Rishi said, sir, you are correct, we have no doubt about it, you are a great learned person, you are the knower of the Puranas, and definitely you have come here, that means to tell a lot of stories about Puranas and the great Rishis and saints and sages. But one thing is, our chief, Shaunaka Rishi, is still performing, he does Upasana, he is still doing his Upasana, he has not yet come out. So, let him come out. Let our Shaunakji, after his daily rituals, Upasana, let him come out, because he is a great knower of Vedas. He is also knower of the knowledge of the Puranas. He is a great Maharshi Tapasvi. He is our Acharya. So he has not yet come. As soon as he comes, and let him ask and the questions, accordingly he will decide on what topic you should speak. इसके बाद कुछ देर के बाद शौनक महर्षि एट कम आउट देन आज शौनक महर्षि केम इज द उग्रशर्व ही ऑफर्ड हिज प्रणाम्स गेव हिम ए आसन टू सिट पुट नमस्कार एंड ही सेड शौनक सेड महाराज ये बताइए हाँ शौनक उवाच शौनक सेड पुराणमखिलं ताता पिता ते धैतवान पुरा Kachitattvamapitatsarvam Adhishe Laumaharshane. Your father, Sutamuni, Laumaharshana. Actually, Puranas, after writing, Puranas was taught to Laumaharshana by Vyasa Bhagavan only. Because Puranas contain so many secrets. It contains geography, it contains astronomy, it contains astrology. It contains so many details. It contains evolution of man on globe. It contains this creation, the details of the creation and past history of the great kings, yuga yugantar history also, not only Kali Yuga but so many years, so many yugas history, full of mysticism, some places symbolism, some places hidden facts. Facts are covered, facts are told, but in a mystical language. Some places sadhana oriented, moksha tattva. It was spread everywhere, all details are spread. So Vyasa Bhagavan had to teach somebody. So he chose Lomaharshana and he taught all the knowledge of the Puranas to Lomaharshana. And such a Lomaharshana is your father. Ugrashrava is telling Ugrashrava. He is your father. And Kachit Vamapitat Sarva Madhishe Lomaharshane. Did you also master all those Puranas from your father? Did you also study? We say na, your aapke pitaji to bahut bada gyani hai, aap bhi unse kuch sikha ki nahi apne jeevan mein, aisa puchte ki nahi log. Your father is musician, aapne kuch sikha? That's a general question. So your father is a doctor, would you like also you to be doctor? Are you learning at least first aid? That is the question. So similarly here you ask it. And then he says, Purani hi kata divyaha adivam shascha dhimatam kathyante ye purasmabhi srutapurva pitustava. What is the Purana? Purana hi actually contains all the katha, stories of what? Divya stories. The stories, that is incidents, events happened not only in Prithvi Loka but anywhere on the in the cosmos. One more fact I would like to tell you, whether you believe it or not, because the times are so changed, so you will not be in a position to think what had happened in those times, what was the condition of lifestyle and all that. A great master has said, the universe is expanding. Even now it is still in expansion. When it is expanding, the distance between stars and planets also is changing. When the universe has come into existence, as per our shastras, when it is the beginning, it expands and contracts completely. But it is still in expansion, it is not in contraction level now. It is still in expansion, it is going on now. Still it is expanding. Compared to many galaxies, they say our solar system and our galaxy is most youngest one, younger one. It is not an old one. It is in 30s, 40s like that they say. Meaning it is still young. Still a lot of time to go and live. In those days, the interaction between beings of different planes was common. Something you can't appreciate now. You can't think because we are so conditioned. We cannot think of those times. So when interaction between those lokas, that's why you find Naradji coming, devatas descending, manushyas also going to, and Gandharvas descending, yaksharas appearing. There was a, confluence of all these people, beings. Even today, people say when you go to Kumbh Mela, you will come across great masters, great maharshis. If you are lucky, they may appear to you. So that kind of a yuga it was. So it is something difficult to conceive it. But that is the truth I am telling you. Because our expansion of time is in so much of time we are talking about. Times will change. This is not a permanent time. This condition also will change. So naturally in those days the entire thing was, so therefore when Purana was told, a story was told, it was never heard with suspicion or doubt. Just as perhaps before the discovery of certain continents on the planet, I'm just telling you modern scientific way. If somebody had told you that beyond the ocean there might be some land, come on, don't tell me, I think this is the end of it. We have reached the end of the globe. That was a thought. Think. It is only when somebody comes there and then makes you believe and then you are also seen, and now that it is all also we accept now it's a globe, it's a continents are there, its map is there, all those things are there. So unless we understand, we position ourselves in those times, we cannot study Puranas. Number one. Certain things are as it is mentioned, certain things are symbolical. Certain things are mystical, hidden, like 8,800 verses in this Mahābhārata was, they are mystical, hidden. So it is tough to understand, yet it can be understood, provided you are taught to the extent possible. So, Puranehi Katha Divyaha. Saunaka Maharshi says, Purana contains the stories of divine stories, Adi Vamsha Ascha. And how the Adi Vamsha, that is in the beginning. Now remember, the basic difference between Western thinking and our thinking, our knowledge is that they start the evolution with primitive men. Are you listening? That is not our story. The fact is that first the mankind, the intelligences were born to guide them. So it is an arch for the high intelligence, and after a long time they devolved and reached a primitive stage of existence. The cycle. Again the intelligences appeared and guided us again to this. So it is not an evolution from point to go up. Actually it is in cycles, or it is in the crest and the trough. Waves. So we don't say that, you know, first human being, the first batch of people who were created, they were unintelligent, nanga gumre the. That is not our belief. Because our creation, from Brahma it came out, with Prajapatis it came out, they are intelligent, mighty, tapasvins, great people. They are the ones who created this. Not the primitive man on coach evolution. That is not our system of our thinking. So believe our shastras, because they are universal, very difficult and deep it derives. That is the truth. So therefore, it contains so many stories, and Adi Vamsha, Dhimatam of those wise people, Katyante ye Purasma Bhe, Sutapurva Pitostacha, and all these things earlier we have heard from your father. Your father used to teach us. We are so happy. There are so many stories are there. You know. We have heard something also from him. Now, Tatra Vamsham Aham Purvam Srotumichami Bhargavam Kathayastvam Kathametam Kalyasmasravanetava. Now, we wanted to know, Shaunaka says, I wanted to know, listen, we want to listen today. Please tell us about Bhrugu Vamsha, Bhrugu Maharshi. Bhrugu Maharshi Charitra. These Maharshis are, even now they are there. Even right now also they are there. They are not dead and gone. They are ever present. So we wanted to listen to you about the Bhrugu Vamsha Charitra. And we are very eager to listen to you. Bhargavam Srotum Ichyami. Bhargavam Vamsham Aham Srotum Ichyami. I wanted to listen the Bhargava, that is Bhrugu Vamsha. I mean, here everybody. Please tell us. Sautiru Vacha. So today, even we have just said what is Puranas. Again and again I am repeating, what is Purana is very important. Puranas actually are the true history of the cosmos recorded by Vyasa. Okay? It is true history recorded by Bhagavan Vyasa. History of the cosmos. So now Sauti Rivaja. Now Sauti said, Maharaji, aapne pucha ki, did you hear and all that? Now he says, Yadaditam Puratam Yagvajasreshtam Yasreshtair Mahatma Bihi. I heard all these great Puranas from my father. And definitely you listen to me now about the Bhrugu Charitra. I shall now tell you about Bhrugu Maharshi, birth and all that. Who is the Bhrugu? Bhrugu Maharshi is such a great person, you know, among the devatas, among the rishis, among the prajapatis, among marudganas, one of the greatest person, Bhrugu. Did you remember, or do you remember, in Śānti Parva, there was a dialogue between Bhrugu Maharshi and Bharadvaja. It was very loaded with knowledge. Do you remember?
Yes.
He asked about astronomy also. Bhrugu Maharshi and Bharadvaja Samvad. So please tell me, Bhrugu. And so this says, Brahmaji in the past performed yajna, and from that yajna, he brought out from that Agni of that performed by Yajna, Varuna Yajna is going on. Varuna is conducting Yajna. In that Yajna, from the Agni, Brahmaji only brought Bhrugu Maharshi out of it. Actually, you know, that the modern science, you know, the actual test tube, that's all not great thing about it. Anything from any medium, any being can be born, provided the sankalpa behind it, the science, deep science it is. From Agni also can be brought out, sankalpa also brought out. So he was brought, Bhrugu's son. And Bhrugu Maharshi's son was Shavana Rishi. He is also called as Bhargava. Shavana Maharshi ka naam suna hoga. Shavana. So Bhrugu's Maharshi's son is, so he says, Shavanasya cha dayadaha pramatir nama dharmikaha pramater yapibhu pramater rapyabhut putro rutyacham ruruhu ityuta. Now, he said from the Bhrugu's son, Bhrugu, Chavana Maharshi was born, and Chavana, son of Chavana was Pramati. Chavana's son was Pramati. He was such a great Mahatma, a Dharmatma. Chavana's son is Pramati. And Pramati married Ghrutachi. He's an Apsara son. So he married an Apsara, Pramati, and Ruru was born to them. Ruru. And Ruru married Pramadhara. To them, Shunaka was born. Shunaka is a name, not a dog here. Shunaka was born to him. And the Shunaka Maharaj also, he became a great Pandit of the Vedas, and he became a great Dharmatma. And thus, the story was told by Shunaka. Shunaka is none other than actually father of Shaunaka. Now you know why he did ask Bhrugu Vamsha, because Hamara Vamsha. Shunaka Maharaj, the Shaunaka asked, please tell us about Bhrugu Charitra. So Bhrugu to Chavana to the body called Pramati to Ruru to Shunaka. Shunaka's son is Shaunaka. In that Vamsa only was born. That will be told later on here. And then the Shaunaka Maharshi immediately asked a question.
Sutaputra yathatasya bhargavasya mahatmanaha chavanatvam parikhyatam tan mamachakshasva pruchyataha.
Now, actually, Bhrugu Maharshi's son is called as Bhargava. And how did Bhargava got a name called Chavana? How he was called later on as Chavana Maharshi, Chavana. Ye jara inka naam kaise badal gaya, Chavana karke. Chavana. Though he is a Bhargava, his name is called as Chavana. People call him Chavana Rishi. Maharshi is. Then the story was told about why his name is Chavana Rishi. Bhrugu Vamsha. Sautiruvacha. What happened? Bhrugoho sudayita bharya puloma iti abhivishrutaha. Bhrugu Maharshi's wife, her name was Puloma. Puloma. Now, Bhrugu Maharshi, wife was Puloma, tasyam samabhavat garbhaha, bhruguvirya samudbhavaha, she was such a great Pativrata, and Bhrugu Maharshi also likes her. And when she was carrying garbha, when she became pregnant and carrying that seed of Bhrugu Maharshi in her bosom, and she was living there in the ashram taking care of Bhrugu Maharshi very well. One day, Bhrugu, every day they had to go out, of course, for bath and other puja on the banks of the river. So Bhrugu Maharshi told his wife that, no, I am going now to the river, that is Nadi, after completing all my work, that is my puja, anushthan, whatever it is, I will come back karke wo bahar gaye apne to take bath in the Nadi and daily ablutions, etc. Then, at that time, what happened? One Rakshasa, and his name also was Puloma. He saw this Bhrugupatni Puloma alone in the ashram. This Rakshasa saw. Tam pravikshya ashramam drushtva Bhrugor bharyam anindityam Richyena samavishtaha vicheta samapadyata. And when he saw her, his kamavasana came out. Rakshasa's kamavasana. She was unable to control that kama, and he lost all his wisdom. Rakshasa, first of all, wisdom nahi hai, but tirvi. He became, and then he said, immediately he went and stood before Puloma's house. That is Bhrugupatni. Bhrugupatni doesn't know that he's a Rakshasa and all. So Bhrugupatni Abhyagatam tu tadrakshaha Puloma Charudarshana Nyayamantrayata Vastvanyena Palamula Dinatada. And she invited him inside, and then she gave the fruit, the milk, etc., and then Atithi Satkar. Now, this Puloma, when the Rakshasa Puloma entered into the house, and he noticed all in the house, nobody was there in the ashram except she alone, and he was extremely happy. Nobody is at home. Drishtva, Drishtama Bhutrajan, she saw again, and then again and again he saw, and then said, there's nobody. Now, immediately, he was happy, and he said, now, I'm lucky today because I found her alone. And he said that, aaj, you know, he thought to himself that now today I am successful. I will definitely take her away out. Why? He was telling to himself, anyhow, I married her time back. Said, no, I married her. Sahi Purvam Vrtatena Pulomna Tu Sushasmita. Actually, the Sautimar says, actually married the Puloma felt, thought to himself that I anyhow married. My married means Varan Kiya Mare. I desired her long time back I desired her. So that day I desired she belonged to me. Now, when he was thinking about himself, he remembered how her father cheated him, Puloma, by not giving his daughter to this Rakshasa called Puloma. What happened was, it is said here, that when she was a child and she was crying one day, Puloma was crying, and the father said, I will hand over you to that Rakshasa. And say, hey Rakshas, tu unke leke jao, karke bol rahe the. Aise bol diye. That time Puloma Rakshasa was exactly there inside the house. And that's why it is said in the footnote that you should not keep the names of the children, any Rakshasa's names like Puloma. Puloma is a name, Rakshasa name. And then also you should not scold your children in this way. Mai tumko bhoot ko de dunga, preet ko de dunga. Bhoot kaun hai? Humko dikha dete hai train mein. Jo hum gaadi mein jaate hai na, dekho baba ji leke jayenge. And chup, immediately the child becomes keep and quiet. Main sochta hu main to paap ka kya kaun se paap kiya hai. And you know, I have too many times it happened. Dekha. In the exhibition show, patala papa me. So, if you are beautiful also, people look at you. If you are dutiful also, people look at you. And if you mind your own business also, people look at you. Bacha image turant kaam ho jata hai, no? The next day till he gets down, you know, even getting down he looks at, no? He just goes like this. That is the contrary here. Baliyar children, they play bapre baba. Bachke rehna padta hai unse. Bhago, bhago, bhago. Today one kid came, Baliyar chahiye. Everybody know, but I will not tell the name. The fellow you are kaam mein bolta hai, joke bolta hai, sabko bolo bolta hai. I am not your spokesperson. Ultimately he made me my spokesperson today. Aaj ek joke bola hai. Main aapko suna deta hu. Chalo. Bachchon ka joke. Bas joke nahi, kuch kahani bolo. Bola there are three birds. So I have to repeat properly. When I am kaha, nahi aisa nahi, aap bhool jate hai. Idhar aao, pehle kaam mein bolta hu. Karke bolte the. Do pair ko. Isliye mera ek minute ho gaya aaj. So kya hua? Three birds are there, I believe. You may be knowing, I don't know. His father says, I don't know, somebody kahan se pick up, kahan se sikhta. Hum to sikhate nahi hai sab. Wo sikh ke aate hai. So three birds aate hai. One is, I should remember carefully the joke, otherwise I forget. I was confused there also. So three birds, one is red color, other is green color, third is white color. Three birds. So first, white bird and I'm thinking now, green bird asked red bird, why are you red? So red bird boli, it seems, boli ya bola, no problem. So red bird told, I am always dhoop mein rehta hun, isliye lal lal ho gaya. Then red bird and white bird asked green bird, I believe, why are you green? So the green bird told, I believe, I take green chillies, therefore I became green. More jyada green chilli kata, hari mirchi. So isliye mein rang bhi green ho gaya. Now which two birds are left now? The green bird and red bird are asking the white bird, why are you white? White bird says, I apply fair and lovely. So I said, ठीक है बाबा, हाँ अब बताओ, बोलता है. Now he tells me in the ear, आप सबको बताओ. So बता देना, I was missing the birds. नहीं पहला पहला सब ठीक से. That's how I remember the joke perfectly. They only taught me. So, बच्चों के सामने इट शुड नॉट टेल दिस, राक्षस को दे देता हूँ तुम, तुमको जेल भेज देता हूँ, तो नरक में पड़ोगे, गुस्सा में है ना, ऐसा नहीं बोलना. बिकॉज यू नो वी वर टॉट वेन यू आर चिल्ड्रन दैट डोंट स्पीक अबाउट सच थिंग्स. इवन इन वेन वी टेल चिल्ड्रन, वेन यू से समथिंग, नो नो I am not well, stomach pain aa raha hai. Immediately mother used to tell, or father, or somebody used to tell elders, no, if you are telling lies, tathastu devatas are there. Those who say instantly tathastu, then you really get stomach pain. So always speak truth, speak shubham, not ashubham. Ear pain, jhoot mat bolna. सच्ची में आ जाएगी ईयर पेन. देन पीपल नो नो तथास्तु देवता, दैट इज मीनिंग हियर. जोकलरली ही सेड, फादर सेड टू मेक हर कीप क्वाइट, आई विल गिव इट टू पुलोमा, एंड प्रियली पुलोमा डेफिनेटली आई विल टेक हर, करके उसी दिन तय कर लिया. सो नाउ ही सेड, यू आर माई वाइफ ऑलरेडी, आई डिजायर्ड यू, सो पुलोमा. एंड देन ही फाउंड आउट देयर इन द हाउस अग्निहोत्र. अग्निहोत्र इज देयर नो, अग्नि प्रज्वलित, गार्ह्यपत्य अग्नि, ऑलवेज देयर इन दैट गृह. सो ही सा अग्नि एंड ही सेड, ये अग्नि तू बता, सच बता दो. नाउ ही सेज, नाउ हूज वाइफ इज दिस, टेल मी, यू आर साक्षी. वाई हिज फादर ओनली चीटेड मी एंड शेमलेसली ही प्रॉमिस्ड मी, प्रॉमिस्ड मीन्स ही टोल्ड दैट दिस पुलोमा ही बिलोंग टू मी, but then later on he married her to Bhrugu. Now you tell, tu sach bolo, o Agni, whose wife is this? Why? You are actually the mukha of devatas, the face of the devatas. You tell me properly, because first it was me who desired her. I have chosen her and I desired her, and it was, but later his father only cheated and married her to Bhrugu. And now tell the truth. Today I want to take her away. And I am very angry at her father. Really that anger, you know, is burning me. This Bhrugu took her away unrighteously. And today I will not keep quiet. And karke bar bar Agni Dev se pooch rahe the ki rakshas. Aur kya kaha? Wo Agni, you are residing, you reside always in all beings. Because in everybody being Agni is required. You reside, you are Jataveda, you are knower of everything, you are Sarvajna, ye Agne, you are also Sakshi of Punya and Papa. You are witness to Punya and Papa. Tell me the truth. Bar bar puchha. You speak the truth immediately. Then I will take this Bhrugupatni in front of you. You are the Sakshi. Dekho Rakshas mein kya baat kar raha hai. तो बिचारा अग्नि वॉज फीलिंग वेरी सैड इन साइड, दुखी दुखी हो रहे थे अंदर, बट यू वॉज स्केर्ड ऑन वन साइड ऑफ टेलिंग लाइज, अदर साइड यू वॉज स्केर्ड ऑफ भृगुस कर्स. एक संकट में इंटरेस्टिंग थ्रिलिंग स्टोरी ना. देन अग्नि सेड ओ सन ऑफ दानवा प्लीज लिसन नाउ. एक्चुअली देयर इज नो डाउट दैट यू हैव डिजायर्ड हेयर. मन में तो वर्ण भी वर्ण कर लिया इन द पास्ट. बट एज पर द विधि एज पर वेदिक मंत्रास एज पर द रिचुअल यू डिड नॉट मैरी पुलोमा. अच्छा दूसरी बात है हर फादर गेव यू गेव हर टू तपस्वी भृगु महर्षि को दे दिया हर फादर. नाउ इवन इफ यू हैड आस्क्ड योर हिज फादर हर फादर सॉरी प्लीज मैरी योर डॉटर टू मी ही वुड नॉट मैरिड. व्हाई ही हैड ऑलरेडी फाउंड ए श्रेष्ठ पुरुष बेटर देन यू दैट इज बेटर देन यू. ही सो मेनी पीपल आर द ऋषिस आर द ही फाउंड ऑलरेडी भृगु महर्षि सो ही वुड नॉट हैव डेफिनेटली गिवन यू had his daughter to you in marriage. That is also for sure. So, therefore, because moreover, Bhrugu afterwards has took her hand, Panigrahanam, through Vedic rituals, mantras, in front of me, and I am the Sakshi for it. So, therefore, Agni or Bhrugu Maharshi also made me as witness for that wedding. And Maharaj, they say, अग्निदेव से आई एम नॉट टेलिंग लाइज जो सच मैंने बता दिया. बिकॉज नानृतम ही सदा आलोके पूज्यते दानवोत्तमा न अनृतम अनृतम सदा न पूज्यते लोके. फॉल्सवुड इज नॉट ऑलवेज रेस्पेक्टेड इट इज नॉट रेस्पेक्टेड इट स्टैंड्स टुडे बट टुमारो इट कोलैप्सेस बिकॉज द नेचर ऑफ असत्यम इज इट कोलैप्सेस. सत्यमेव प्रतिष्ठते. So, therefore, I am scared of speaking truth in a lies also. The falsehood cannot stand for longer and I told you what I wanted to tell you. This is the truth. As soon as this was told, Rakshasa immediately took the form of a Varaha. Varaha form and took Puloma with high speed. Wind, whirlwind speed. Stuck. Uthake leke gaye Rakshasa. To whom? Puloma. Now, in that Garbha, Bhrugu Maharshi is the seed she was carrying pregnant. And who is inside? Chavana Maharshi was there. And in the swift movement of that pregnant lady, that Puloma, wife of Bhrugu, when she was being taken away in that high speed by wind speed, by this Rakshasa, the Garbha inside was so unhappy and he got very angry. So angry, and out of his yoga shakti, he just came out and fell down. Yoga bala. See, it is very clearly done. Yoga bala only, not ordinary bala. He decided, and yoga bala ke saath bahar aa gaya. When he came out through his yoga bala, since chutam took place, meaning chutam means fall, achyuta means never falls, one who never falls, therefore achyuta, achyutam, achyutam, achyutam. Here chuta, tatasya garbho nivasan kukshau bhrugu kulottaha roshan matuhuschyutaha means he fell down, kukshe chavanaste naso abhavat, therefore he became chavana. See, it is very clear, very wonderful. So since he fell down out of that womb, that is from the mother's womb, since he fell down, he became Chavana. Because Chut hua, isliye Chavana ho gaya naam. Chavana Maharshi is a great Maharshi, not an ordinary man. But now, as soon as he was born, he was shining like a sun shines with a very tapasakti tejas, and the Rakshasa saw him. As soon as he saw the born baby, that is Chavana Rishi, he was burned to ashes, unable to bear the light and heat of that born child, tapashakti, the tejas. This Rakshasa was burned to ashes. And the moment Rakshasa was burned, the Puloma fell on the ground unconscious. And after some time, she slowly got up, became conscious, took the child in her lap, in her hands, straight went to Brahmaloka. She was crying and standing before Brahmaji, the baby inside. So Brahma saw her and said, She saw Brahma saw her crying and a baby in her hands. She was crying profusely, and Brahma addressed it because a vadhu he addressed, because that is daughter-in-law only actually, you know, bahu actually. So because Bhrugu is son of Brahma, so Bhrugupatni, so daughter-in-law. So he, Brahmaji looked at her and consoled her. What happened? And she was crying, and that water became like a river everywhere. Like a river. So when that river became, she cried, it became a huge river. Do you know volcanoes in the earth and all that? They are similar to abscess in our body. Same proportions continue in the cosmos also. Just as our physical body is there, Bhudev's physical body is there, earth. So she is a living entity. If earth is a dead planet, no seed would grow, no plant will grow, no animal can take birth, no human being can survive. It becomes dead planet. Dead planet means no life can live. Because she is living, the metabolism in the earth is taking place. When I leave the body, metabolism would stop. When I am there, metabolism continues. When earth, the Prithvi Mata is there inside, that spirit which is holding the earth, we have seen that Kashyaparushi entered into earth and continued for 30,000 years. When Prithvi Mata got angry and left the earth and went away, earth was unsupported. Immediately Kashyaparushi entered into the Prithvi and continued the work of Prithvi Devi, Bhudevi, for 30,000 years. Where did we read this? Mahābhārata. The time we saw that, what is the, that, so if you leave the body, metabolism, everything stops. When metabolism in the earth form stops, no chemicals are formed, no chemical reactions takes place, water cannot form, earth cannot be fertile. Everything stops. The plates has to move, continents are formed, mountains are formed, mountains are crushed, oceans are adjusted. So much of dynamic movement is going on in earth even now. Every moment, explosions, volcanoes. Is tamasha hai jaisa? Are you visualizing? I don't know. So this is, so much of activity is going on in the earth. So when this she went, and that crying became big river, and Brahma named as that river as Vasudhara, Vadhusara the name he named. And the river was following her wherever she was going. The river was following, and when she reached ashram, Bhrugu Maharshi was there in the ashram. He saw the Chavana Rishi, the baby, and also Bhrugu, and crying, and the river. He got so angry. Tam dadarsha pita tatra chavanam tam bhaminim sapulomam tato bharyam bhavachak kupito Bhrugu. He was so angry to look at her and said, come on, tell me, who introduced you to that Rakshasa first? Who has revealed your identity to the Rakshasa? The Rakshasa who came to take you away. Come on, you tell me first, who introduced you, who identified you, who revealed your identity to the Rakshasa? Puloma said, Agni. Agni told him about me, but actually then he was taking away this, the baby born, the fell from my womb, Garbha, and because of that tejas, the Rakshasa was burned to ashes. and somehow I am protected today because of this sun. Otherwise, Rakshasa would have taken me. Karke, she cried and she told the truth. Bhrugu Maharshi got very angry. Immediately, he cursed Agni that may you become Sarvabhakshi. Sarvabhakshi means eating everything. Sarvabhakshi. You know, anyway, there are secrets. That way we can't complete Mahabharata also. Science also is now discovering. Already their theories are there. Fire is a form of energy, is it not? And fire itself has many manifestations. And what is Agni? Agni is not that flames only. Agni is a principle. Heat is a principle in the universe. It has many functions. It can be invoked also, of course, through flames. It has many functions. So what does become Sarvabhakshi? That we will see after the story. He becomes Sarvabhakshi. Agni Deva said, Maharaji, you know, it is not right on your part to curse me like this. Maine kaun si paap kiya hai? And you became so adventurous enough to curse me. Because you have not thought of the consequences. And what is my mistake? Tell me, what is my mistake? Because I always follow dharma. And I always speak truth. And I spoke truth only. Why should you curse me? What did I do? I didn't do anything. Now you tell me. You are asking me. Now, if I don't tell the truth, if as a sakshi, as a witness, if somebody asked me, you witnessed it and you tell what you have seen, being a witness, having witnessed, if I don't reveal what I saw, as per the Shastras, 7 generations after me, 7 generations before me, they all would suffer terribly. If I don't speak truth, that what I have seen. Now, same time, if you know the truth, or if you know something, and if you remain quiet without opening the mouth, then also the same problem of 7 generations down the line, 7 generations before, they would suffer. तो मैं मौन रहने से भी एक पाप लगता है, झूठ बोलने से भी पाप लगता है, तो मुंह खोल के सच बोलना ही पड़ेगा मुझे, मैंने सच ही बताया. Now, I can also curse you, but I don't want. I can also curse you. And I become what? Through yoga bala, bahudhamanam katkrutva tishthami murtishu agnihotreshu satreshu kriyasucha mukeshucha. I take many forms of fire. And I express in different forms, and I am there in agnihotra, I am there in satra, yajna yagadi karmas, I am in every karma and the agni is required, and also I am in a mukha also. As agni I am seated there. So I spread myself all over the universe and take up different functions. Now, vedoktena vidhanena mayyadhute havihi devata pitarascheva tena trupta bhavanti vai. Now, devatas and pitru devatas, to devatas and pitrus, when we people offer in my mukha ahutis, actually they are feeling contented and happy. I am only a carrier, I am only an agent. Think. So when everybody is happy, so devatas are happy, pitrus are happy, because when you offer something to my mouth, they are all happy. So now unnecessarily you have cursed me. And you tell, whatever the devatas and pitrus are surviving, only when you offer into me mouth, my mouth, they also eat what you have offered. They eat actually. Therefore, actually, I am called as Mukha of Devatas and Pitrus. I'm the face, I'm Mukha. And very, very sad on your part to curse me. Karke, Sauti continues. After he said that, he disappeared completely. And he withdrew the activities or role, what he has been doing in the universe. For some time, he withdrew from the job. This extraordinary job of carrying ahutis from this place to that place. When Agni is refusing to work, how do you yajna yagadi karmas you do? Samajh mein aaya aapko? If Jataragni is refusing to work, how can you eat food and digest it? If body temperature is refusing to support us, how can we survive? If the Agni is a devata for speech also, if he is not there, without that fire in the speech, how can we speak? Think. So, he had disappeared. And all Agni Karyas have stopped. Rishis wanted to do everything, but Agni is refusing. They are not going. They are not, Ahutis are not reaching them. Pitrus are Devatas. The Rishis are, Pitrus are Devatas. So all Rishis immediately went to Brahmaji. Actually, you must all look at it as the history of the Devatas. Certain principles, if they are suddenly non-operative in the universe, certain laws become non-operative in the universe. Remember, when there is a lawgiver and law administrator. Without a lawgiver and law administrator, no law can survive. Think. A law is given by, suppose, a few people constituted together and some cabinet, whatever it is, they discussed. Suppose I'm just giving a laukika law. A law in a physical level. Law is given and law is passed out. Bill is passed in Lok Sabha and new law is brought out. So you say that the government is a law giver. So there's a law. They conceived a law and they gave that law. Who will administer the law? Think. So that law has to be administered, followed, stick it to everybody by everybody. That is the law. Now the other law is given. If you are not following this law, then another law is given out as a punishment. Laws are there in our country or in the world, but how many of us are following them? Think. Aapko samajh mein aa raha hai? So devatas are law administrators and Ishvara is lawgiver. So he had given a law, Parameshwara, and law administrators are these people. And every law in the cosmos, the laws of the cosmos, the physical laws, chemical laws, if they are changing, you cannot study science and technology. Did you get my point? The laws are changing. Boiling point of water, 100 degrees. The law is changed. Now what will you do? Everywhere there is a law. Sun rises, sun sets, law. Revolution and the rotation of earth, there is a law. Everywhere there is a law. Heartbeat, law is there. But more than that, problem. Less than that, problem. Body temperature, it's a law. Definitely, you are not maintaining your body temperature. It's a very great tapas when you should think, you know. So when suddenly certain laws become inoperative, Because of the refusal of law administrators to implement the law, there are the problems at the cosmic level which are to be dealt by the Ishwara only, Creator only. So therefore matter cannot exist as a law. I'm just telling a little 2 minutes, I'll spend time on this. How can a matter, see, there are two things in the universe. One is matter, insentient and sentient. Now, sentient alone controls the insentient. Insentient cannot control the insentient. And insentient cannot control the sentient. Think. And that sentient, you understood? Sentient, nothing but is it intelligence, suppose we accepted in the universe. Intelligence cannot exist. Intelligence is there. And there are two things in the universe. One is sentient and insentient. This intelligence, to whom it does belong to? Insentient or sentient? It has to belong to sentient and not the insentient. If intelligence belongs to insentient, then the glass will decide, mic will decide, chair will decide, everything will, they will decide, matter will decide for us. So there is an intelligence in the universe is noticed. And intelligence, there are only two expressions in the new, in the creation, sentient and insentient. And intelligence cannot belong to insentient. Intelligence can belong to only to the sentient. So the sentient is referred as intelligent. Intelligent meaning is sentient, meaning one who is possessing intelligence, meaning he is a conscious entity. Samajh mein aaya ki bouncer ho gaya. So a matter cannot exist without controlled by a sentient being. So sun cannot exist without being controlled by the spirit ruling over the sun called Surya Narayana. The earth cannot exist without being controlled by the spirit called or intelligence called or sentient being called Prithvi Mata. Think. Therefore, any law, there is a being. So that Agni being, Agni Devata, who is controlling and administering the law of principle of fire in the universe, suppose he is, becomes inoperative, it becomes a big problem to the sustenance of the universe. Bahut badhiya ye sab janna chahiye. Then you know you don't question Bhagwan hai kya. ये सब जड़ पदार्थ ही है, ये पृथ्वी तो जड़ है, क्या मुझसे वह क्या बात करनी है, पुराण में पूरा कंफ्यूजन है, सूर्य भगवान से प्रार्थना की, सूर्य भगवान प्रकट हो गए, वो क्या थोड़े प्रकट होता है, ये तो हीलियम और नाइट्रोजन का रिएक्शन है, वो तो फायर है वहाँ पे, और कुछ नहीं है, ये तो मैटर है, और कुछ नहीं है. द प्रॉब्लम इज देयर इज नो ग्रे मैटर इन अवर हेड. यहाँ प्रॉब्लम बाहर का नहीं, यहाँ पे नहीं प्रॉब्लम. हाउ कैन यू से नाउ यू टेल मी देयर इज अ वाटर गैंजेस रिवर सो गंगा माता मस्ट बी देयर टू कंट्रोल दैट गंगा. ए ट्री इज देयर, ए ट्री इज कंट्रोल, स्पिरिट इज देयर, इंटेलिजेंस इज देयर. मानते हैं कि नहीं? ठीक है. पता नहीं क्या बोलता है. नहीं, कभी कभी उनको बेचारा ऐसा हो जाता है, उनको कुछ कुछ की बोलता है, कुछ भी समझ में नहीं आता बेचारा. बहुत सिंपथी है ना, बेचारा पागल होते होंगे वहां बैठ के बेचारा. Then you know, when you understand, you can talk to sun, the moon, the star. astonished when Agni said like this and disappeared, when all Agni Karyas have stopped, they went to Brahmaji. Brahmaji called Agni. Hey, Agni, idhar aao pehle. Pagal hai. He said, you know, bhayat, see, lokanimeha sarvesham tvam karta chanta evacha. Baba, you are karta. Agni is very important. Role you are playing in the cosmos. Sa tatha kuru lokesha no chidye rin yatha kriya. You must perform and function in this world in such a way that there should not be any lacuno in the very functioning of the world, and people should be happy, and because of you no trouble should be there. That is called living. Aap aisa jeevan jiyo. Ye kya jeevan aapka? And then he say, kasmad evam vimudhatvam. How can you become so vimudha? Suddenly you become so pagal kaise ho gaya tu? You are so knowledgeable, jata veda hai. Itna bevukufi kaisa ban gaya? Suddenly you are withdrawn from activities. See? Vimudastvam Ishwarasanhutashuna. You are Ishwara because you are everywhere there. You are Sakshi, you are Punya Papa Sakshi. You are Agni Devata, you are carrier of your agent, you are Jata Veda, you are Sarvajna, you are residing in every being. Such an important role you are playing. How can you become suddenly a fool and give up your activities? How can you? Suppose you know, wife criticizes husband and his husband goes and resigns and comes back in the evening. Is it foolishness or not? Her husband criticizes or scolds wife and wife stops functioning. Aasya mai kana nai pakaungi. Everybody must have told at least once in life. Mahamantra. Tumlu hotel mai jao. Whatever I cook, nobody likes at home. What is my janma? It is useless janma. Ticket, ticket, and hit the wall. I cannot make so many tastes at home. Ek item dete hai mujhe. I will not cook anymore. From tomorrow onwards, kitchen closed. Go. Suppose kitchen closed, who will be at loss? Because sab log bahar jaate ghoomte rehte hain, acha kaake aa jaate hain. Mom kaake so jaate hain, and you will be alone sitting in the room. Waiting for public sympathy. And they are so tired to sympathize with you. So they sleep. And you further boil inside. Poocha bhi nahi koi khana khaya ki. Maja, 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 maja. Then 12 baje raat ko akela jaake. I'll tell you one incident here. In our own ashram it happened. Somebody came. Some person. He is an excellent person and he is given that room, our guest room. An acharya, some acharya. So it was meant for acharya, so acharya. Sometime 2-3 acharyas came. I said, you three log wahi pe adjust ho jao. Ek acharya ke saath, unke do pehchan jaan pehchan log hai, hrusht prusht, like Upamanyu. Bhul gaye joke. Upamanyu. Upamanyu, kya kha rahe? That joke. And they were given the picture behind them. And first class food was available. I don't know, they felt that, you know, we are not ordinary people. We are kuch business, one puja hai some temple. Toh kya hua tha, hum toh ashram hi hai. Toh unko room diya gaya. That Swami, some person said, Acharya said, you please go both of us. So we just taken and room and was saja. Pata hai kya hua unko dono ko. खाना नहीं खाया, कमरे में नहीं आया, बात भी नहीं किया, उनसे भी बात नहीं किया, हमसे बात नहीं किया, हमसे बात नहीं किया तो आई एम वेरी हैप्पी बिकॉज वन लेस पर्सन इन टू टॉर्चर मी इन लाइफ, दैट्स हाउ माय माइंड वर्क्स. तो एक आन मुझे छोड़ दिया तो मस्त, मुझे बात नहीं किया. फर्स्ट क्लास खाना पकाया हमारा ठाकुर महाराज ने, उनको खाया भी नहीं. वो बोलता है कि स्वामी सब खाया ना, दो लोग खाया ना. तो बोला छोड़ दो भैया, भूख ने भेजा है उनको, पूछा नहीं, सब सो गए उनके खाने को. 12 बजे बेवकूफी लोग दोनों चलते चलते जंक्शन पे जाके रोटी खा के आया, 12:30 बजे रात को. सम गुस्सा समवेयर, नॉट ऑन मी, समथिंग हैपेंड, आई डोंट नो व्हाट हैपेंड. केला खाओ, नहीं कुछ नहीं, भूख नहीं, रात को फिर जटराग नहीं ना, वैसे आप भी लोग हैं स्ट्राइक में जाते हैं अकेला रात 12 बजे खा के खुद पका के खा के सो जाते, तो किसका क्या जाता है। Therefore here, how will you leave that job responsibility responsible? Then Agni just took it, head bent down. Then he said, don't worry. No, you will not become Saurabhakshi as easily. Through your apana, jwala, you become Saurabhakshi, not through mukha. So Agni has many faces. So lower form of Agni is the one which is taking care of the functions of apana functions, excretion, digestion, toxic substances and the heat which is there in a toxic as a acid, heat, etc., toxic substances in the stomach, and they are all that kind of agni, low agni, which is digesting all those things. Apna maamsa khayenge, kuch bhi khayenge, all bekar. And also he did this, the other agni also, jo chita, to burn the dead bodies. That form of agni which consumes it is a lower form of energy, which is difficult to discriminate, and science has already pointed out that there is, in fire itself, there are many different fires. I am yet to get that paper, I am waiting for it. So there are now theme, there are so many flames, are there, so many fires, are vibjar, like, you know, sapta jwalas. Like radiology, which color? Certain colors only kill certain things and all that. High sophisticated lights will not help in healing the gross body. So many things are there. So that he was asked, and therefore atse tum mukse you take ahutis, but apana jwala se you do this lower kind of sara bhakshi bana. Whatever bhakshi you want, we can eat anything when burnt. Thus you convert that curse into a great blessing in the universe, Brahmaji told. Behave like that, and the Agni was very happy after listening to this, and Devatas happy, Rishis were happy, Agni also happy. Agnischa paramam priti mavapa hata kalmashaha. He became all pure inside, and he also participating. Thus the Agni Deva was cursed by Bhrugu Maharshi, and but then Brahmaji helped, and this is how I narrated the way you can take it. ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ओम शांति शांति शांतिः। हरिः ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरिः ओम सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय। एनी अनाउंसमेंट्स?